Hello, folks, and welcome to the Vertigo Tea Party. And let's try Ice Lakes. It's developed by Iceflake Studios. You can pick it up for $14.99 on Steam for Windows, Linux, Steam Play, and Mac. It supports Steam achievements, Steam trading cards, and cloud saves. I will be playing a free press copy that was provided to me in order to make this video. So, first things, let's just go ahead and hop into a game so you can see the gameplay. Once we've done a little 10-minute session here, I'll hop back out and show you some of the details. This is an ice fishing game. Don't let that put you off, though. And obviously, if you're going to like that kind of game, I think you'll know right off the bat. There's no like fantasy element. There's no combat, anything like that. There is item progression, so there is that. So when you start off, there's a few modes, and again, I'll get to that in a little bit. I always like to just start off with gameplay, so we hop right into it feet first, and then, you know, kind of double back and see what the details are. So we're going to go out. We're competing with these other folks to, in this case, get the most fish. So let's look at the UI really fast here. This is a single game tournament. There's a little bit later on you can do tournaments where there's multiple days and multiple tournaments, I guess, combined into one big tournament. Anyway, this one is by total weight, so whoever catches the most total weight in fish wins. This is the time left. We have 9 minutes and 18 seconds, and that is in real time. This is the temperature and the wind speed, which I guess affects what you can catch, but I'm not quite sure how that works. We have a mini map over here. You can change it between, or you can basically turn off and on depth. I strongly suggest having depth on because it's very important. And you can zoom in and out. So let's go ahead and drill a hole and start ice fishing. Now there are multiple things that you can purchase here. For example, this drill here is actually not the one you start with. I bought a bigger one. It's a little slower to drill holes, but it drills bigger holes because the default one, the hole is a little bit too small to catch bigger fish. And you can get different types of baits as well. So let's start off with this one. We'll go ahead and drop it in there. Or that is a jig, I guess, not a bait. It's important we get our fish terminology correct. We are going to drop some lure in there, which attracts certain fish that we're trying to catch. And I'll hold left click, and I'll move the rod around to see if we can't get a bite. Now, you'll know you're getting a bite, as you might imagine, from when the end of the rod starts to bend. And how much it bends tells you how big the fish is that is on the other side. So one difficult thing about this game that they do not explain very well, maybe on purpose so that you can kind of figure it out for yourself, is the movement types for the different types of jigs. So we see we get a bite. So I'm going to hit, you can hit F or you can jerk up on the mouse. It's actually much better to just hit F because a lot of times I'll do the jerk up motion with my mouse and it won't like register. It wasn't enough. So I might do it again, but by the time I've done it again, I've missed out on the fish. So you saw we got a pike. There's like 15 to 20, probably more than that, types of fish in this game. There's quite a few. Obviously, again, we want to get the most total amount of fish. So we're going to drop this back down in here. And you can also see here the hole is starting to fill up with ice. If you don't clean it out, you can see now I'm not able to move the line. So we'll click on our skimmer here and clear that out. You can also press R to do the same thing. And I would highly suggest pressing R to do it. It's just much easier. Let's go ahead and do this again. I'm also using a heavy duty rod. That's another upgrade that I purchased so that I can catch bigger fish. The positive thing is, well, I can catch bigger fish without the line breaking. The negative is that smaller fish, it becomes harder to see where the end of the rod dips. At least I believe, from what I can tell, that's the big difference. It says more or less sensitive are the big rods like this one. I presume that means that, again, the smaller fish, it's harder to see. And from my experience of using it, that seems to be the case. When lighter weight fish tend to hit it, it's often very difficult to see because the tip of the rod just barely moves. Let's drop some more lure in here. One of the big problems I have with this game, and some might actually view it as a positive, and in some ways I see it as some aspects as a positive, is it doesn't really explain very much at all. Now, they do have an official Steam guide on Steam, that shows you the absolute bare bones basics. And I should have let you see there, but the tip was just barely moving. Tell me there was a fish, but I might not have noticed. Okay, we did get it. And it was a very light fish, only 0.18 pounds. Very, very light. So let's actually change up the lure. But to kind of finish up what I was saying, they do have a guide showing you the bare bones basics, but there's a lot they do not cover. Let's go ahead and switch to, I would like to catch, again, all of these, pretty much everything in this game has this little eye informational thing next to it, which tells you which fish it's best for and what fish it's good for, which is actually very, very handy because, like I said, there's a lot of different things, lures, rods, etc. in this game, and it helps it to, helps you keep track of that. So let's go ahead and pick this. I like Xander's. So we're going to switch our hooks. Or I'm sorry, we're going to switch our jigs. And because we got a different jig, now we can actually use baits. Some jigs you cannot use bait on. We want to go for, what did I actually say? This was good for. Xander. Xanders are good because they're nice and heavy. And because this contest is based on weight of fish, we want to try to catch Xander. So which one of these is good for? All right, this one, we'll select it, say okay. Takes a little bit of time to bait the hook, or bait the jig. Let's clear out the ice. And let's also switch this out. I think I have something for Xander. Yeah, there we go. Switch to the golden balls. I'll keep the jokes that I want to make to myself, and we'll drop some in there. And now we're actually going to fish a little bit different. Because different jigs work better with different movement of the mouse, different speeds, different motions, etc. But again, the game doesn't really tell you that. Sometimes it will mention it in the tip screen, but otherwise you're kind of on your own, which is a bit of a bummer because a lot of times I was getting very frustrated. Oh, I don't think there was actually movement there. I was getting frustrated early on with the game because I just couldn't. Oh, I guess there was, and I still missed it. And it's still got the worm on it, so let's drop it in. By the way, you do not have to have the worms on the ends of these specific types of jigs, but it does increase your chances of getting stuff, getting fish. So let's go ahead and keep doing this. But anyway, as I was saying earlier, I was getting frustrated because I wasn't catching anything. And it was a mixture of a few things that I didn't know what I was doing wrong because there's a lot of moving parts to how quickly you catch fish and what type of fish. Depth matters. Temperature, I guess, matters to some extent. I don't know in what way. The type of lure you're using, the motions that you're making with the rod, how fast you're making movements with a rod, etc. All of that seems to factor in, as far as I can tell, into what kind of fish that you're catching. So this worm's almost gone, so let's bait it up again and drop it in there. And all of these movements I've found has just been through experimentation. Like I've tried all kinds of different things. And like, for example, this type of jig seems to work better when I do more of a kind of like a slow cursive W. Just kind of have to watch for the rod movement here. And again, depth matters as well. So if I bring the lure up higher, I'll catch different types of fish. Though the movement is going to stay the same. Got another flounder. Like, for example, these flounders you will only catch at the very bottom. Let's go ahead. We don't have a whole lot of time left for this tournament. Let's throw it in one more time. We're fairly close to the starting area because you do have to stop and go back to the starting area before the time's up or you completely lose the tournament. There probably should be two different terms for the tournament because there's ones that are just individual tournaments, but then there's tournaments that consist of multiple tournaments all combined where you get a score at the end of each one. And then whoever has the highest score by the end is the overall winner and takes the prize. All right. It is much harder to see the small bumps with this thicker rod. In fact, I should have switched rods just to kind of show you, but all right. Let's go ahead and pop up out of here. Now, on longer tournaments, you're going to want to move around. You're not going to just pick one hole and stay there the whole time because eventually it will run low on fish, and you can still catch fish, but you'll catch it at a much slower rate. So let's go ahead and head on back, and you know the starting area by the little flag icon on the mini-map. And once you get in here, you just kind of wait. The AI is fairly smart and will not disqualify itself. However, sometimes I don't know if the character just locks up or what, but they just will never come back. They'll just sit out here. And in fact, maybe this person will do just that. But it's fairly rare that they'll disqualify themselves due to running out of time. So once this tournament ends, we'll look at the results, and then we'll look at some of the more in-depth aspects of this game as far as purchasing upgrades and things of that nature. 8 seconds left. And that person never even budged. So I guess they just kind of got stuck. Oh, wow. We did really terrible that time. Wow. I usually am number one by a fairly large margin. So we did pretty. But then again, I was talking a lot during that one. But you can also see no matter what you place, as long as you don't disqualify, you get a reward. And it's basically money, but I have to call it fish bucks because it's a coin with a fish on it. And as you might imagine, you use the fish bucks to buy upgrades and different kinds of things, which we'll take a look at now. Let's go ahead and just hit continue. And that brings us back to the main screen. So first of all, let's look at the different game types. First, you have these tournaments. We have, it's like, what's this? Like 10, 12-ish different maps. And you can always see the types of maps on the right-hand side here. You can click the informational button. It'll tell you what type of fish are in that lake, the max depth, the biggest fish that you've caught there, and the rewards. As far as I can tell, every single map has the exact same rewards, which is kind of a bummer because some lakes are harder to win on than others. So if you really just want to get money as quickly as possible, it's actually easiest to stay on this first lake and just keep racking it in. Now, it's not necessarily true that these higher level lakes are quote unquote harder to win tournaments, but I do find generally on this forest lake, I tend to just blow them out of the water, no pun intended. As far as other settings, we have evening, noon, and morning. I guess that affects what types of fish you catch. Again, I'm not sure. It doesn't really tell you. You also have seasons, winter, autumn, spring. You don't have summer, probably for obvious reasons. You can also change the time of the tournament. It goes from 10 minutes, 15, 30, 45, an hour, hour and a half, 2 hours, and 3 hours. And one of the big reasons you would want to go with a longer tournament is the longer the tournament runs, the more money that you get. So if you just do a 10-minute, I think first place is like 800. I have no idea how long the 3 hour one. And again, it is in real time. So that is 3 real life hours of tournaments. So you better be ready to, because I don't think you can save in the middle either. So you better be ready to stay in for the long haul. You can also pick the type of tournament it is. That one was by total weight. That's the default. So basically whoever catches the most fish by weight is the winner. You can say free fishing, no time restrictions. So basically you just kind of fish until you're bored with it. A total amount. There's all kinds of different options here. 3 biggest fish, most different species, only perch, only trout. I think that's really cool. I really think it's neat that you have all these options, especially stuff like most species, because otherwise the game would be a little bit too limited in that, oh, okay, I just want to be able to catch the fattest fish that I can and win by weight. There's a lot of different categories so that you can mix it up, and you know, you have to know your lures, know your rods, know your locations, know your depths in order to win, which I think is actually really cool. So we'll go back. Let's look at tournaments. Now, tournaments you cannot control. Let me try to forfeit. Okay, because this is actually the second time I'm recording this. And I had started doing another basic training one. I've actually finished the basic training tournament. Don't let that name fool you. It doesn't really train you to do anything. It's just the earlier areas. And like I say, and I'll probably hit on this several times, my number one complaint with this game is they just throw you out there with absolutely no real training or explanation. Other than these little eyes, which are handy, but there's a lot of information there that they don't tell you, which in some ways is a good thing, and we'll talk about that a little bit later. But anyway, as you can see, we've got all these different tournaments, and they all have different criteria, which again is kind of cool because it mixes it up. So here it's fairly basic, right? You have three different lakes, and you can't click on them, unfortunately. But the first one is by weight, the next one is by how many fish you catch, and then the last one is by the biggest fish that you catch. So you might have to use different strategies going in so that you win that specific round of the tournament. We'll call those rounds. You'll want to use a different strategy for different rounds, because what you did to catch the most fish might not win you the one that makes it where you have to catch the most weight in fish. Let's go back in here. And just clicking on it, I guess, makes it start it. It's kind of weird. But yeah, there's all kinds of different ones. This one is using a very specific bait. This one's only catching a very specific type of fish. And you can see there's quite a few of them. Quantities, deeper water fish, longer days, things like that. So there's a fairly good variety with the tournaments. There's also online. I haven't messed with the online at all. I don't know how popular it is. I don't know how that works at all. So you have to check separately on how the online part works. Next, let's take a look at the various equipment that you can buy. It does start you off with some basic stuff like this Red Devil and whatnot. You have, first of all, you have the jigs. And these are categorized differently. We have Mormishka, Balanced, Vertical, Spoon, and Spinner. Again, I have no idea what the difference in these are. The game doesn't explain at all. I feel like they assume if you're playing this, you understand this stuff by default, or they just never got around to explaining it. I definitely think that's the number one area they need to work on, because a lot of people are going to pick this up and be completely lost. Like, why should I buy a spoon versus a vertical versus a balanced? What's the difference? I have no idea. They really need to explain that type of stuff better, because there isn't anything here. But again, you can click on these. It'll tell you what they're best for and what they're good for, as far as just, you know, catching specific types of fish and the price. And you can see they get pretty pricey. The lowest, for example, the lowest price spinner is 500 fish bucks, and the most expensive is 2,000. So I presume, and generally I found the case to be that the more expensive jigs and baits and whatnot tend to be for specific types of fish. So in other words, rainbow trout, brown trout, and salmon tend to be on the more expensive side of the scale when it comes to any kind of equipment aimed at catching those types of fish, if that makes sense. So, and I found too that brown trout, for example, tend to weigh more. So I think that may be why that is. I'm not 100% sure. Now we have different kind of equipment, and yes, you do have different types of drills. You have the light is what you start with. However, you can't catch anything over a certain size. They won't fit through the hole. The medium allows for a little bit bigger hole, but it's a little bit slower to drill the hole itself. And then the heavy will allow any fish to come through, but it tends to be quite slow to drill. One thing that doesn't make any sense at all is some of these drills look exactly the same if you look at the stats, but they have different prices. So for example, this heavy standard, if we look at it, it says also the biggest fits through the hole, which a little bit broken English there, but that's okay. It's a large width and a slow speed. Now, if we look at the other heavy, it says also the biggest fish fits through the hole, large width, slow speed. So it's the description is exactly the same. However, there is a 2,000 point difference, or a 2,000 fish buck difference. So what's the difference? I've not seen any kind of durability listed on the drills, so I don't think they break. So I have no clue why you would want to buy the more expensive drill as opposed to the lower price one. You also have a bunch of different rods. Some are better at catching smaller fish. So again, competitions where you want to catch more fish, and like if whoever the winner is, whoever catches the most fish, you might want to use this, because these, I've noticed these rods, the ones that are good at catching the smaller fish, also tend to reel in and reel out faster. So you can kind of be more rapid fire as opposed to the heavies, which are a bit slower. However, obviously they also catch bigger fish. And we have our baits. We have the various types of baits here, and again, you can click on them that shows you what types of species of fish they're best for and what they're good for catching. And as with the other things, some cost more than others. And again, you notice again, brown trout and rainbow trout are listed here on the very expensive types. You have lures. This is just what you drop into the water to draw those specific types of fish. Hooks you use with certain types of jigs, which again, aimed at certain kinds of fish. So the progress in this game, or the progression in this game, is pretty cool. I do like the progression. I feel like there's two types of progression in the game. There's one, the obvious. You get money so that you can buy better stuff. So you buy the better drill so that you can catch bigger fish. You collect money to buy the bigger rods so that you can, well, catch bigger fish. You also are able to buy more lures that are more specialized for the types of fish, depending on the lake that you're in and the target that you need to beat, or target that you need to meet for that specific tournament. So there's that obvious type of progression, right? Just buying advanced and varied types of things. There's also a progression of just kind of learning what fish and what styles work for meeting certain goals. So for example, I found that the bigger fish tend to be at the bottom of the lake. So the deeper areas are what you want to go for if the tournament requires the heaviest fish, or the largest fish caught, or the most weight in total. I want to catch the most heavy fish that I can, so I'm going to shoot for fish that live near the bottom of the lake. If it's a contest where I need to catch the most fish, I might want to fish near the top of the lake with a lighter pole, because it's faster. I can get in, catch the fish, reel it up faster, and I get back to the depth that I need to get to faster as well. So it's just quicker overall. So there's just two types of progression. And that's where I was talking about earlier, where I feel like them omitting some information may be viewed as a good thing. For example, I've learned that, you know, certain fish can only be found on the bottom, like flounders, for example, are only found near the bottom of the lake. I can't catch them near the top of the lake. That kind of stuff I'm okay with figuring out on my own. However, things like what's the difference between these types of jigs, I feel like that kind of information should be there. I feel like the information of the very bare bones basics should be given to you. How you use that information to catch fish and to win tournaments, that's the fun part of figuring it out for yourself and like trying different things and figuring out what works and what doesn't. I feel like that's fun. So maybe don't give us too much information, but explain the basics. So anyway, you can customize your character. You can make female characters. You can make yourself right or left-handed. You can pick different hats. There's not a ton of customization, but you're not looking at your character a ton anyway, so I don't think it's a big deal. You can also check your records. You can see how much money you've earned, things like how much time we've played. I've actually played this game quite a bit. You can see your overall record in competitions, how many tournaments you've done, and you can redo tournaments again and again if you would like to. So if you don't do well in a tournament, you can do it again. How many fish I've caught, it also breaks it down into the specific types of fish that I've caught and how much they weigh, the biggest fish of that type I've caught, etc. So that's really good for those of you who like to keep up with that kind of thing. So last, let's look at statistics. This actually can be very, very handy, because I've come back to this and said, okay, well, I want to win this tournament where it's the most weight of fish. So I will look through and go, okay, you know, perch, these don't get very big. I've caught a ton of these, and the biggest one is only 1.5 pounds. But if I go back and I look at, let's say, Xanders, I see, oh, wow, there's actually, half of these fish have been over 1.5 pounds. So these are the fish that I probably want to shoot for more often. And I can click the various ones, and it shows me exactly on the lake where I caught that fish. Not only that, it tells me the season, the time of day, the temperature, the wind speed, what rod I was using, what jig I was using. All of that information is there, which is pretty awesome. It helps you, again, kind of look at your history, learn where you can find those fish at more often, and maybe even the size, maybe they're even larger sizes might congregate in a specific area. So it's really cool if you're really going to get into it, you can track that information and see for yourself where that's at. Lastly, let's look at the settings, and I'll probably do one more round of fishing here real quick so you can take a look at that again. But we have, you know, standard stuff, the graphical options here. Audio, we have the audio volume, the music volume, and we can turn sounds on and off. And the music doesn't actually play, I don't think, while you're fishing, which is weird. You can change your language here, zoom speed. And this, actually, I changed all of this stuff. Distance unit, you can use feet or meters. Weight units, you can use pounds or kilograms. You can use the change of camera mode, time format between 12 and 24 hours. Secondary mouse, I forget what that does. That show chat, that's probably the online thing. And then you can change your key bindings as well, which I have not actually bothered to do. But yeah, let's go ahead and I'll wrap up my final thoughts here. We'll go ahead and do one more game. Let's hop onto the fishing islands. Let's make it, let's try it spring. And we'll go with, let's go with total weight again. That's my, you know what, let's go with biggest fish. Whoever gets the biggest single fish is the winner. So we'll hop on here and I'll talk my final thoughts. Now, first of all is the price. I've heard a few people mention that $15 seems a bit much for this game. I can't entirely disagree. I feel like the price is a little smidge high for this game. I feel like for most folks, $10 would be a better price point. $15 does feel a little excessive for what's given to you, and it might have locked up. I had this happen one other time where I was loading the lake, and it never did load. But out of like 7 or 8 hours, that's not too bad. Let me stop recording real quick and pick you guys up in a second. I'm going to restart the game. All right, so we got it back in. Yeah, if the game doesn't load within like 5 to 10 seconds, you know that it is probably locked up. And like I said, that's only the second time that's happened. And it could be because I'm recording. I do not know. So I like to zoom in once we kind of get an idea. And I don't know how close, like proximity to other fishers matters. I would think it matters a little bit because like I say, with longer tournaments or longer rounds or whatever you want to call it, I have found that eventually the hole stops giving fish as fast as it used to. All right, so let's go ahead and bait this thing up. Oops, I didn't pick a bait. We're going to go with Xander again, I think. There we go. Bait it up. I think this is good for Xander, right? Yes. And I believe this is also good for Xander. I should have bought some more. You can actually buy bait here during the tournament if you need to at the fish house, I believe. I've actually never done it, so let's actually drop some of this in here. And let's get fishing here. So final thoughts. I kind of left you guys off on price. Like I said, I feel like it's a little bit high. Naturally, for what is it, $15? I feel that's a smidgen high. However, for me, if you're gonna be the type of person who really wants to dig into this and use it as like, I had a tough day at work, I just want to get in and relax, then I feel like it's a game you'll probably come back to. Maybe not play it for 30 hours straight over a week or something like that, but it's a cool game to come back to. I'll say this, like most times when I do these let's tries, I will play the game, enough, and I'll make the video, and then I'll usually uninstall. But, oh wow, we're not catching squat with this. Here we go. I'll usually uninstall it, but I'll probably leave this game installed for a while so I can come back to it and try different things. It's like, for example, I've had this curse. Like, I cannot find rainbow trout. Like, I have tried everything I can to find rainbow trout, and I have just not been able to catch them. I don't know if it's because I'm in the wrong season. I've used bait and jigs that say they're for rainbow trout, but I absolutely cannot find them. So I'm obviously missing something. So I feel like it's one of those games you can come back to, maybe not spend, like I say, an entire week playing it. But in that event, I think it would be worth $15. And generally, if you're watching this, you probably know if this is the game for you. This is definitely not going to be a game for everyone. So it seems like it's helped by the way that we've moved up not so deep A nice pike. I like pikes because they are quite, tend to be quite heavy. Which is what we want. Still a little bit of worm on there, so let's drop it in there. As mentioned before, my number one complaint is lack of explaining even the basics. Yes, they do have a Steam guide that shows you, again, basically the stuff that we've covered now, like how to use the rod, how to bait, how to, you know, buy your tackle, things like that. And they've got a more advanced guide coming, they say, but that stuff should be in game. That should really be in game. And again, we don't need to go so far as to say, okay, you know, tell me how to catch every type of fish, but explain the difference. Oh, wow. Nice. That's a big one. Go ahead and skim that out. Explain the difference. What is the balance jig? Like what, why is a balance jig different than the first type of jig versus the other types? Like I have no idea what the difference is. And also there's a lot of information they give in the tips that I've noticed that is useful, but there needs to be somewhere that actually I can access that. That's not on a loading screen tip. Like put that in a help section somewhere. There's going to be a lot of people who want to play a game like this, like myself, who don't know like the first thing about ice fishing. Like when I was younger, I used to like to fish, but I mean, we're talking very basic stuff, like throwing a worm on a hook and a bobber and just throwing it out there, right? That kind of thing. Definitely not ice fishing, that's for sure. So they really should do a better job of explaining a lot of that. And I feel like a lot of people are going to be frustrated by picking this game up. And because it's an indie game and because it's not overly popular game, it's hard to find that information. I never thought I was going to Google this, but like I was Googling like what's, you know, how do I properly use a balanced jig? And I couldn't really find any information because I was hoping, I'm assuming a lot of that stuff is based off how you use it in real life, right? So if you, you know, do very quick motions with it, like back and forth motions, or if it's very slow and deliberate, woo, that's going to be a big one. That was pulling down very quickly. I'm interested to see what this is going to be. Ooh, oh, wow. 4.36. That's nice. That is quite nice. And there is that awesome feel. I will say one awesome thing about this game is especially when you're using these heavier rods, when you see the tip like really pull down hard like that one, there is that, ooh, yeah, like you're really getting excited to see how big and what type of fish is on the other end. So that it has that aspect to it. And like I say, I have been playing this game probably just tonight for like 3 or 4 hours, and I keep saying, well, I'm just going to do one more 10-minute tournament, and then I'll be done. And then I finish it, and I'm like, well, I kind of learned a little bit. And I got some more money. I can buy some more jigs. I want to try something a little different. See what happens. So it's got a weird version of that just one more turn syndrome that you normally see in stuff like Civilization. But I've actually quite enjoyed it. I've enjoyed it more than I thought I was going to. I thought I would like it okay because I kind of like these laid back games where it's, you know, you can, you know, play so many games like Doom and Dark Souls and all of that. It's nice to have a game like this where it's more relaxing and just very simple pleasures type of appeal to it. And it definitely can get frustrating when, like I say, like with the rod movement, like trying to figure out what works and what doesn't. It makes it worse when you think you've got it figured out and then all of a sudden it seems to stop working. It's like, okay, was there a change in the weather that caused the problem? Am I doing something slightly different that I'm not aware of? Is it because of, you know, the depth that the lure is in? Things like that can be a little frustrating, but again, they can be rewarding as well. Just because you, again, when you do figure out what works and you're like, you go from, oh man, I just cannot catch a fish to save my life. And you make some small changes and then, you know, all of a sudden you're getting bites every 15 seconds. That's, again, in its own rewarding because you figured it out on your own. So that kind of goes back to what I was saying about how some information, it's kind of good that they don't have it listed there because you can kind of figure it out on your own. But I do wish that they were a little bit more upfront with at least some basics of moving the rod, because it's so hard. They don't tell you anything at all. And it's like, okay, well, it's like, and they, in the tips, they'll sometimes mention like, oh, you know, you need to use, if you're using this type of jig, you need to move, make fast movements. It's like, okay, well, what do you consider fast? Is like this is like, is that, I'm assuming that's too fast, or is it too fast? Like, and what is slow? Is this slow, or do we have to go like really slow? And then obviously there's some common sense. Like I would consider like this to be fairly slow. And this would probably be what they would consider fast. But again, I don't know. There's zero frame of reference for you to know. And again, you kind of have to figure that out on your own. It's like, okay, well, if I'm getting hits every, like I drop the line in the water and every 10 seconds I'm getting a hit. Okay, I've probably got the movement down for this jig. And most of the time, like I say, it's not too difficult to figure out. But I will say the balance jigs, like I struggle. I still don't know. I've spent a ridiculous amount of time trying to figure out the movement speed and type for balance. And I absolutely cannot figure it out. And again, I don't know if it's a movement issue. I don't know if maybe those jigs are only good for a specific type of season or a specific type of depth. Again, I've got no idea. And the game doesn't give you any frame of reference. And on one hand, you could argue that, well, you know, that gives you a reason to experiment and learn it for yourself. But there's, on the other hand, again, there's so many factors in if a fish is going to hit. Again, the jig you're using, the bait, the lure, the depth of the lake, the season, the temperature outside, the movement of the rod. It can be so difficult to narrow down, okay, why am I not catching this fish, that it feels like you're facing the insurmountable. And we got number one, thanks to that one big old fish that was at 4 pounds. We got 800 because it was only a 10 minute tournament. But anyway, yeah, that is Ice Lakes. Again, I really like this game. I like it a lot. I've already put in, how many hours did I say? I think it's under player. Yeah, almost 10 hours now of this game. So I'm liking it quite a bit. I'm going to keep playing it, most likely. Probably not constantly, but it'll be a game I pick up every now and again when I kill a little bit of time. So definitely check it out. I will have a link to the game in the description below the video if you want to check it out for yourself. And also make sure to leave any comments in the comments section below. If you'd like to see more coverage of games like this that you may not have heard of, make sure to subscribe. Follow me on Twitter, and I'll see you next time.